Hi, and welcome to a new VPS Avenger update video where I want to show you a new feature of the version 1.7, which is called the event trigger. And the event trigger can do cool things like triggering audio events on certain input trigger events. That means, for example, you can assign a note off to a sample, to a multi-sample, or any MIDI CC, or even the macro button can trigger a sample. And yeah, let me show you what it can do. So in the first column, you can choose what trigger you want to have to start your audio event. For example, we can now choose note on. At the moment we're still playing OSC1, let me mute OSC1. So now we can select click samples or even normal multi-samples. So now it behaves like a normal sampler module, but I can assign this to note off, and now you can see it will be triggered when I release the notes. And together with the normal OSC, you can create wonderful release samples. And yeah, for example, let me use each slot has, of course, an envelope. Thing is, you now can even do a routing here. And reverb, for example. And what's even cooler, you can route it into a certain effects bus. That means I now route it into FX bus 2, and now we can choose a transgate. Or phaser, whatever. Bit crusher. Yeah, as you can see now, it's set to global MIDI. That means any key you press will trigger this. You can, of course, if you have a sequence of multiple oscillators, then they will appear here, and only these oscillators then trigger the sample when being released. And of course, you even can specify in which region on the keypad this sample, this release event should be triggered. And if you set it to C0, then only the note C0 will have this event triggered. What else is cool? It's a probability. So you have a certain amount of randomness here. Use this one. If I set probability to 50%, percent, for example, only in 50% of the cases this event will happen. This is cool if you have slide noises from fret noises from a guitar or something like this. and you don't want to have this triggered all the time. It should be more human factor, have more human factor, more randomness, then you can use the probability. If it's set to zero, of course nothing will happen. Of course you can automate anything here. And yeah, the pitch is another cool thing. For example, you can assign an LFO to it. And you even have a pitch envelope. Blade Runner style. Or doing something crazy for effect sounds. Yeah, and of course there are some more features, and you have a spike parameter to strengthen the attack. It can have a delay, great for bells or guitars, which should have a bit of strumming feel. Of course you have the filter. Also very cool when applied on an LFO or something like this. Then we have kind of random sample starter. Let me choose a plucked sample maybe. Maybe the bells again. So of course you can have a key track. Now everything plays at C, or the root of the multi-sample. You can have a random sample. In a multi-sample there are 20 or more single samples, and you can let Avenger choose randomly one of these. I don't know if you can hear it. Maybe it's better, you can hear it better here. And then we have the same, but without following the pitch you play. This is good for noise samples, like an attack sound from a piano, which has no tonal information inside. So now the pitch is not longer relevant, and you can... These are the plain multi-samples on original pitch. Like I said, good on atonal sounds, like I have here some release samples, for example, from the Grand Piano Expansion. And we have here this is a multi-sample consisting of 88 different release samples, and these are now shuffled in random. If this would be with pitch, then you can see it's still nice, but it's now more of an effect sound. So, okay, and what else do we have? We have, of course, the possibility to trigger with MIDI CCs. This is a table of all MIDI CCs that are existing. And if we now take, for example, the CC64, which is the sustain pedal, now we can see there is a smaller S sign. If the CC is smaller as 64, then it's triggered. And now let me plug my sustain pedal. Yes, okay, so I have to reverse this. Now it's when it's pressed down, the sample will trigger. I'm now triggering with my foot the release pedal down. Let me raise the volume a bit. And you even can have a second sample which will be triggered on lifting the pedal. This will be then here, and let us choose a different. And now I'm releasing it. Louder. Works. You even can trigger something. Let me disable this. And you even can trigger something, for example, with aftertouch, which is quite nice. Unfortunately, this keyboard does not have aftertouch. Otherwise, I would show you. But there are so many possibilities here with press controller, ward wheel, and so on, expression pedal, and even MIDI controllers you have on your external gear. And you can have Avengers macro button, either on or on off state. Let me put this here. Button one off state. You can trigger certain crash sounds or whatever, shouts, one shots, on certain events inside of an SQ. So yeah, this whole section is quite performance saving. So you can also use this as a gigantic stacker of 16 samples on Node On. We can now choose. Just three random sounds. So, as you can see, you can use it as an additional oscillator for just playback samples, normal samples. With a probability. So, okay, I hoped you enjoy the new feature. It's for free. It's in the 1.7 update, which you can download now at our website. See you soon in next video. Bye for now.